Benny. What's up, buddy? What's up?
What in the goddamn?
All right, King.
Things have been a lot better since.
What about Rex here?
What about him? I don't know. Maybe. If you found a.
Your best bet will be to talk to Julie Farkas over at the old Mormon.
Man,
fort
Julie
north
fixes
of here.
Everything.
Maybe you have
Julie's
better luck
a
than
fucking
I did.
God. Julie is an absolute goddess.
Sure can. I have a friend who has. Just tell Ralph that I sent.
Alright, thanks, dude.
Aye.
Now what? Oh, I gotta go to Mick and Ralph's anyways. So now the fucking knife kid can finally convince me to go to Mick and Ralph's.
Come to Mick and Ralph's for all your
shopping.
Yeah,
don't
needs.
Shank me, please. I don't trust him. Hey, Dixon.
Looking for a fix, man?
Yeah, I got
a
deal with you.
Yeah, man. Those cats are out of their domes and... Really? Ah, you're such... You know what? I might be willing... Wait, man. You can't go around saying shit like that. Okay,
yeah.
I get your point. You wanna...
Good. Good.
Bye.
Drug dealer taken care of. Let's go to Mick and Ralph's.
How's it going?
What's up, Ralph? Hi, Ralph.
If you're looking for guns.
Hey, man, the king said you can set me up with a pass to get into the strip.
One of his boys stopped in and said you had won the king's favor. You've done.
Hey, thanks, man. Counterfeit passport.
Take a gander.
Let's see what we got here. This guy's got all kinds of neat stuff. Aid. You have, like, real aid? Fuck no, he's got, like, sunsets or sarsaparillas and fucking purified water and pylon nuts. He ain't got anything of value in here. My man! What's up, Major D? Welcome in. Oh, yeah, do you know where I can find a sex bot? I mean, Ralph, this is a weird request. Do you have any idea where I can find a robot to have sex with?
Are you some kind of machine fetishist or something?
The Garrets have a certain... customer that my closet. Jesus Christ, Doug. The Garrets are looking to satisfy certain customers.
Well, the only place I know of locally would be Cerulean Robotics. That place has been overrun by vermin for years.
Overrun by vermin.
If you want to check the place out, you can find it on the west side of Freeside. The entrance is on the back side of the building. Just watch out for thugs. The rats aren't the only vermin you need to worry about.
Ah, damn, I'm gonna go get... Thanks, I will check it out. Is there a holotape or anything I'll need for the sex bot? My guy... How would my guy... The space pope does not approve. How would my guy know that I need a holotape? Like, I have a one intelligence.
Well, I don't know of any, but if you give me a few days and some caps, I think I could probably make one on my terminal.
How many caps you need, dude? Oh, Ralph, I've been directing a lot of business your direction. How about we call it a favor? I met you 11 seconds ago, but let's call this a favor.
All right. Come back in a couple.
Attaboy. Is the holotape ready yet?
Not yet.
Aw. Are we there yet? Are we there
Thanks
yet?
Thanks for stopping in.
Are we there yet? Anyways. Head on out of here.
Hey.
What's up, Dixon? He's got a toy gun. Oh boy, Max. Oh, here's another junkie guy. What's this guy doing? Being a junkie? Jacob Hall.
You have chems, buddy? I could. Why stop? I feel great.
Well.
No worries. My guy will be here soon. If I had two caps to scrape together, I'd buy the materials to make my own. This guy named Dixon. Something about him seems sketchy, but I can't stop now. At this point, I'm mostly buying his stuff just so I don't feel sick. Speaking of which, Do you have any spare caps?
Abso-fucking-lutely not.
What? I need a fix now!
No, you're...
Fine. If you really care so much, then give me some shots of Fixer to calm down these shakes.
Some shots
I'm gonna
of
need
Fixer?
At least 10 shots.
10
the week.
Shots of...
From there, the follow...
Bruh. Man, I am the most charismatic guy on Earth. Jacob, just be strong, man. You just need the support of your friends to get through this.
I think you're right. I've been through worse. I'll go to the fort and see if the followers can watch over me while I recover.
God, I hope they can, man. Freeside, I'm accepted by Freeside. What a nice guy I am. What, empty... Oh, this guy's addicted to jet, like, really bad. Huh.
Come on, man, I'm dying here.
What about it? Dude, Julie and the rest of your friends miss you. They need your help.
Oh, Julie, I really... I'll head over to the fort and get some rest. This is going on.
Atta boy. I'm proud of you. Jesus, man. Have some whiskey. Curious what he's got on him. 23 bottle caps. That's crazy. All right. Anyways. Return to Julie Farkas, which I have to go talk to anyways. Hey, Julie Farkas.
Is there something you need?
Yeah, we have a lot of problems here, Julie. Helped with the addiction problem.
I saw them. Thank you so much for helping them. This means a lot to the followers of the apocalypse.
Yeah.
You have our thanks.
By helping them, I forced some pretty shitty withdrawals.
With Jacob working with us, we should be able to spare a stim or fixer once a day.
Nice. The king, though, the king says I can, you can help with his robot dog.
Rex? It breaks my heart every time I see him. He's such a good dog. Yes, a few months ago. We had to tell him there was nothing we could do. No, Rex's condition is way beyond anything we can handle. He requires brain surgery and some sophisticated cybernetics work, too.
So, what you're saying is that somebody can do that.
There's an old scientist named Dr. Henry who reportedly specializes in this sort of procedure. He'd probably be your best bet. Last I heard, he was living up in Jacobstown, far to the northwest.
Things have been a lot better since you helped with those soldier boys. She said, what? Why didn't she just say so when I was there? Actually, come to think of it, I was pretty angry when I went down there. I vaguely recall something about upending a few tables, maybe knocking out one of her doctors. Anyway, that's incredible news.
Yeah, that's incredible news.
Only thing is, there's too much going on around here for me to make a trip like that. And I need all of my guys just to keep things settled here. You seem to be awfully interested in my boy Rex here. And you've done some good work for me already. I'll tell you what. You promised to get Rexy here to that doctor, and I'll lend him to you. What do you say?
Oh, hell yeah. Abso-fucking-lutely.
I can't thank you enough. Now, there's a few things you should know about old Rex here if you're going to be traveling together. First, he hates rats. Can't stand the things. Giant rats, mole rats, doesn't matter. He catches a whiff of one, and he's off like a shot after him. He's normally pretty obedient, but you might have to chase him some if he goes after one of the little varmints. Second, he doesn't like hats or the people wearing them. Don't ask. I have no idea why. Maybe because it rhymes with rats. That should be it, though. Other than the occasional bad spot when his brain starts hurting him, that is. But I'm hoping you will see to that. I wish you both luck. Take care of my Rex now, you hear?
God damn, I got Rex.
This is your new master. Protect him as you would me.
Hell yeah, old buddy, old pal. Rex, come with me, buddy. Atta boy. What a good boy. Aw, look at him. He's so cute. Alright. Rex, we got places to be. We're gonna kick down a door. And by that, I mean we're gonna walk through with our fake passport. We're gonna just stroll right into the strip. Not a thing they can do about it. We're gonna go make fat stacks of cash on the Vegas Strip. What's up, guy?
You look new to Freeside, so here's a little advice, friend.
Thanks for the free advice.
The name's Old Ben. I've been living in Freeside since the day I was born.
Oh, have you now? So what's your story?
I've done a bit of everything around here. Courier, butcher, crier, escort. Gun for hire.
Wait
Some
a minute.
Some of which I'm not proud of, but I do my best to help around town when needed.
Wait a minute. You said you were an escort, like an armed guard?
Well, I suppose you could look at it that way, but I was packing a whole different kind of heat. No, escort just sounds better than man whore.
Ooh. Oh, so you got paid for sex.
Yep. I was damn good at my job, too. But after a while, I just felt like a piece of meat and had to quit.
Well, about that.
Exactly one of the reasons I got out of that job. Too many shifty characters looking to have someone else move their hot items.
But so, here's the thing. Like, let's talk about something else. How would you like to work for the Garretts? Are you a smooth talker?
But life has been a bit dull without some kind of action.
He's
What's
a suave talker. Garrett needs a real boyfriend experience for their more discerning patrons.
Ah, I get you. So you think because of my past escort work, I'd be interested in that kind of thing. I got out of that work because it just made me feel empty inside. What makes you think I would ever go back to that degradation?
Well, Ben, you give your clients a precious respite from the ills of the world.
I never put much thought into the well-being my clients got out of my services. I suppose they only get as much as I put into it. Tell Garrett I'd be happy to start at the Wrangler immediately. This should be a nice
Attaboy,
change of
Ben.
Pace from retirement.
Bye. Bye. See you, Garrett. Oh, look at that guy. He's going. Dude, you're almost... Well, you were almost there. Jesus. That seemed extreme, guys. Seemed a bit over the top.
Submit to a credit check.
I have a passport.
Thank you, sir. You may proceed.
Yeah, no problem. Hey, you don't want to go be a robot man whore, do you?
Move along.
No, apparently not. And welcome to the New Vegas Strip.
Howdy, partner.
Oh my God, it's Victor.
Peace, haven't you?
What's
welcome
up, Victor?
To New Vegas.
Put me to the tops, Victor. I've got a score to sell her.
Sorry, Rambler. I know you're fixing to serve up some vengeance, but I'm going to have to point you to the Lucky 38 first. Mr. House, the head honcho of New Vegas, is itching to make your acquaintance. He'll help you serve that cold dish of yours extra chili.
Why is a robot passing on his invitation?
Well, now... It was Mr. House who made Securitrons like me. Seems the least I can do is pass on his message. Don't dawdle. He'll be waiting.
He'll be waiting.
That's it. Keep moving.
What? What if I don't want to go talk to House? I want to go just kill Benny.
Gonna have words with your commanding officer after this.
Why do they call it a monorail? It's a train! A train!
Wow.
We leaving already?
You guys are having a hard time here.
I have half a mind to throw you all in a cell and let you sweat it off.
You guys are really having a hard time with us.
Look alive, guys. You know, I swear the monorail was just ahead.
Fine, I'll go talk to House first, I think. I still have this dog with me? Hey, Rex. What's up, Victor? Let me in.
Well, howdy, partner. Good to see you. I see you brought a friend.
I go where I please, attack. Okay, that's fine. Yeah, no problem. I'll head up myself.
Come back.
Stay, Rex. In the old Lucky 38. Jesus, he got robots everywhere. I go talk to Mr. House. Oh, hi, Mr. House. Oh, whoa. Calm down.
This meeting has been a long time coming, hasn't it?
You've come a long way,
literally and, I suspect, figuratively as well. I have to ask, now that you've reached your destination, what do you make of what you see?
A city devoted to vice and sin. What's not to love? What the hell are you?
A crude question, crudely asked. I'll be happy to satisfy your rambunctious curiosity at a more appropriate moment. But now, I'll repeat my question. What do you make of what you've seen?
Motherfucker, I might. A city devoted to vice and sin. What's not to love?
Oh, come now. Don't play the fool. Vegas has fools enough. A superfluity of them. They're what makes it so profitable. They come to Vegas chasing penny-ante dreams of high living, to feel like they're big shots, like they're winners. You see that you and I are of a different stripe, don't you?
Sir,
we don't have to dream that we're important. We are.
Sir, I'm an idiot. I'm a lumbering oaf. Like...
Oh, don't be coy. You've been playing a high-stakes game ever since Victor dug you out of the ground. Don't be afraid to admit it.
I really haven't, though.
The business is this. One of my employees has stolen an item of extraordinary value from me, and I want it recovered. Simple enough.
What do you propose?
My only concern is the recovery of the platinum chip. What happens to Benny, I leave to your discretion. When you bring the chip to me, I will pay you 4 times the delivery bonus stipulated in your contract.
I don't even know what
How's
my contract
that?
Said I was going to get. It's a good start, but well below market price. It's a good start, but well below the market price.
Very well. 5 times the bonus. Not 1 cap more.
1,250 caps. The chip is worth far more than that. Whatever.
Well enough. Return to me when you have the...
Yeah, dude, I'll return when I have the chip.
Until then.
What if I don't want to give him the chip? Like, fuck that guy. What if I want the chip?
Enjoy your time.
What's up, Victor?
Congratulations, partner.
I got a high roller suite
too. Just bear in mind, you're the only one gets... Enjoy the...
That's fine. I'll go to the casino. Thanks, dude. Benny. What's up, buddy? What's up?
What in the goddamn?
Yeah, it's me, homie.
Let's keep this in the groove, hey? Smooth
moves. Smooth.
Hello. The guy everyone saw going the Lucky 38, that was you? Oh, shit.
Oh, yeah. Seems you need to work on your marksmanship, homie.
I hit what I was aiming for. Guess you had brains to spare.
No, I don't have spare.
Or you just thick skulls.
Brains to spare, dude.
Either way, baby, this
I can barely
good
speak
news.
English.
Maybe I can finally sleep at night, knowing you didn't die. What say you and me cash out? Go somewhere as more private-like. Any questions you got, I'll answer.
Yeah, give me the platinum chip.
I can't do that, baby, and you know it. There's a lot of angles to this caper. Complexities aplenty. But plenty of action, too. Enough for both of us. But we don't jabber about that out here in public. Like I said, we should be talking somewhere as private.
Yeah, this dude's gonna run.
To start, I'll comp you the presidential. Best suite in the house. You deserve a taste of the VIP lifestyle. I'll hang out down here for a while to make everything look business as usual, then come to you. Any questions you got, I'll answer. Guaranteed.
Yeah, dude, this guy's gonna run away. Suite's a nice touch, but someone's got to pay off my contract.
Where's my manners? Here's some cash up front. There'll be more where that came from. Wait for me in the presidential suite. We got a future together, you and me. It's time we got started.
Yeah, this guy's definitely gonna run away.
I got my eye on you.
business. I know funny business.
That's all right. Search Benny's room for clues. That's a plunger. Does that count? Oh, look at all these caps right here. Oh, damn, now I feel rich. What's that? It's a goddamn fresh apple. Search Benny's room for clues. I would love to.
Baby, this little meet and greet of ours, it would be 41 flavors of stupid to let you get a drop on me. And you forced my hand. Hell, I gotta skip town because of you. A real pain in the caboose.
Yeah, that happens.
A lifelong learner is you, eh? Then make your questions count, because your lifelong is running life short.
All I am is a courier trying to fulfill my contract.
All this is just work ethic run wild? That's your line? I don't know. Can you get it through your thick skull to leave me and the chip alone? If bullets can't get through, what hope is there?
Dude, I dig your line. Let me live, you'll never see me again. You're a dead man. Nah, let me live, dude.
God damn it. I'm actually gonna let you live? What's come over me? Scramsville, baby. The stripping you part ways, dig? You come around me again, you won't be getting back.
Is that
up.
A challenge? So I will take that challenge every time. Ooh. Ball safe locked average. I need a lockpick skill of 50 to do that. Do I have anything that says I can up my lockpick? Aid. No, apparently not. Oh, who are...
The eyes of the mighty Kaisar are upon you. He admires your accomplishments and bestows upon you the exceptional gift of his mark. Any crimes you may have perpetrated against the Legion are hereby forgiven. Kaisar will not extend this mercy a second time. My lord requires your presence at his camp at Fortification Hill. His mark will guarantee your safe conduct through our lands. Incidentally, it will interest you to know that the man you seek has fled the strip and is likely making haste for Kaisar's camp as we speak.
Ooh. This is a trap. I'm going to take a lot of you with
me. The mighty Kaisar has bestowed upon you his mark and guaranteed safe conduct. If he wanted you dead, he would be dead already.
Oh, no, no, I wouldn't be dead already.
Cove, south of Nelson.
I absolutely would not be dead already.
Will be waiting.